When Allah gives us too much, we forget our Lord even in our salat. And that's what Iblis said. He said, لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ I shall sit awaiting for them on your straight path. In their salat, I'm going to wait for them. In the Quran, I'm going to, meaning when they recite, I'm going to wait, I'm going to whisper. I'm going to make them turn even their worship into a sin. Even their worship into a sin. So that when they pray their salat, they're thinking of the dunya. When they're fast, when they're reading their Quran, they're thinking of showing off. They're thinking of this thing and that thing. I'm going to make them forget with the ni'mah and the blessings. And Allah says to him, go ahead and bring to them the wealth and the horses and the luxuries of the world. Distract them with all of that. There was a man who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who said, Ya Rasulullah, I am stricken with poverty. For many years of my life, I have suffered from poverty. And this Sahabi, he used to come to the masjid. This man came to the masjid, 5 daily prayers, even in nafils. In Ramadan, he was there in i'tikaf in the last 10 nights, always there, remembering his Lord. He said, Ya Rasulullah, can you ask Allah just for one thing for me? He said, what do you want me to ask him? He said, ask Allah to give me some wealth. Al Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam looked at him. Now, you know, when a Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam looks at a person, he can tell what kind of a person this is and in which state they are better. He said to him, but I fear that if I ask Allah to give you wealth, it will distract you from the good work and the closeness you have with your Lord now. You will lose what you have of ni'mah. If He gives you that blessing, you will lose this blessing. And this blessing is far greater. He said, no, I swear that I will stick to it. So then the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did. He asked Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And so Allah opened the doors for this man. Allah guided him by granting him a business in sheep and goats. And his business grew. Suddenly, as you would expect, he started to come to the masjid less often. Then his prayers became once a day in the masjid. Then it became only Jumu'ah. Then Jumu'ah was gone, only on Eid. And then that was gone. Started praying at home all the time. Al Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked about this man. And they said to him, oh, a long time ago, this man forgot the masjid altogether. His wealth and his business distracted him until he had no more time. He has no more time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that a person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives too much, what happens to this person sometimes? They say, this is all from me anyway. Isn't that right? It is from my knowledge I got this. It is from my work I got this. I inherited it from my parents.